Hi, I'm Buzz Bishop, and I'm going to show you how to add lightsabers to your photos. This is all resulted from a trip that I took with my sons last spring. We went camping at a place that had a desert Tatooine kind of feel, and as they climbed the mountains, they pretended they were Luke Skywalker, Darth Vader, whoever, and they were having lightsaber battles. They didn't have their lightsabers with them. They were just mock holding them, and I went in afterwards and using Pixlr added lightsabers to the photos. They loved it. I'm not a photo editing ninja, but I'm going to show you how I did it using Pixlr. Pixlr right here is the address. It's a free photo editing program. It's very similar to Photoshop, and it's really easy to use. So first thing you need is a lightsaber. You can find one at ThinkGeek. Just an image of it, right, is all you need. I've used this one in the past, but the one I really like is this one that I found from Lucy L on PhotoBucket. It's using a transparent background, and so it's very easy to add right to your images. So I've just saved that and brought it into Pixlr. First thing you need to do is to cut the handle off, because what we're going to be doing is adjusting the color of the blade of the lightsaber. So get your lasso tool and simply draw around the base of the lightsaber and cut it off and add it as a new layer, and then just drag it to rebuild it again, so that when we are editing the colors of the image, we're only working with the blade. So go to the blade layer here, for me it's layer 0, up to adjustment, and then hue and saturation. And this is where you can mess with the color. You can make it brown, red, green, purple, blue, whatever. So my boys really kind of like being Yoda. So we'll choose a green lightsaber for one of them. And then there you go, you've got it. So let's bring in the image that we want to work with to add the lightsabers. So we went to Mexico for spring break, and they posed like they were holding lightsabers. So let's add the lightsaber to it. So first you have to merge the layers, copy the image, and then bring it into your other image here. So, and then I will unmerge the layers so that I can change the color for another one. All right, so let's work with this. We've got this lightsaber as a layer on top. So first things first, we need to change it and get it on the right angle to go in my son's hand. You use that by selecting the layer and going to free transform, okay? And then you're gonna get a box like this, and you can shrink the size of your lightsaber just by using the keys. And then if you move it just a bit to the side, you can rotate it. So we can get a good size and angle of this lightsaber to appropriately fit my son's hand. So that looks pretty good to me. Pretty decent sized lightsaber. And we accept the changes. Perfect. Now, the only problem is it is behind his hand. His hands are behind the lightsaber, so we need to bring it forward. So to do that, all you do is again grab your loop tool, and then trace around the parts that you want to bring forward, and then you copy and paste it. You have to drag it over top, so here's his hands. We'll drag it back over top. Make sure layer 2 is above layer 1. And now it looks like my son is holding the lightsaber as it goes through his hand. All right, perfect. So now let's go and do it for my other son. So again, we work with the layer and we go to adjustment, hue. Let's make him evil here. Well, I have it on the wrong layer. So let's make him more like Darth Vader. So we're gonna choose a red hue for the lightsaber. Kind of Darth Maul-ish, right? Okay, so that one is good. We will merge the layers. Copy the lightsaber over. Simple. Again, go to Edit, Free Transform, and now we need to rotate it all the way around so that it is perfect for his hand, and shrink it down to his four-year-old hand sizes. So again, you just kind of line it up on top, right? You want to get the angle perfect. This free transform is really easy to get things in. And then you can decide if you want it to be in the front or the back. Since my son's foot is in front here, we'll put this lightsaber in behind. So that's a good position for it for me. And now we'll go back to our main image and loop out my youngest son's hands, the parts that you want to cut and paste on top. Copy them, paste them, and then we'll bring them forward as a new layer up on top of everything. Right there, and bring it all the way up on top. So that is on top. So now you can see he is holding the lightsaber. Actually, you know what? We're going to delete just a little bit to make it look like it is in the palm of his hand. Just like that. So it looks like his hand is coming through. And now we'll put this lightsaber in behind this one. And now you can see that the orange lightsaber is behind the green one. And you have your two kids who look like they're having a lightsaber battle on the beaches of Puerto Vallarta. Simply save out the image and then you can show it to your kids. Here are some of the other ones that I've done. I was trying other techniques previous before I found the right lightsaber. I couldn't rotate it properly, but I've had them fighting on the sides of mountains, again on the beaches. And then this is the original one that I first did, their first lightsaber pose, where I like to have it on my Facebook page. I've used it on the Dad Camp as a sticker for my MacBook, and it's pretty much part of the Dad Camp branding. So I hope you enjoyed this edit tutorial on how to Photoshop lightsabers into photos of your kids. You can find the article with more instructions at dadcamp.ca. as well as a pin that you can share with your friends. Thanks for watching, and make sure you check out dadcamp.ca. May the Force be with you.